Still walking slowly and helped by two assistants, Jose Salvador Alvarenga made his way into a room of waiting government officials and reporters. He's now clean-shaven and got a haircut, but still seems dazed. When given the opportunity, he only said he was grateful. I would like to say thanks to the government of this place for supporting me and for being my friends, he said. Thank you for taking care of me and helping me feel better. After this brief appearance, officials say, Alvarenga's health took a turn for the worse, and the fisherman was taken back to the hospital to be fed intravenously. Doctors say his limbs have been swelling, and they seem unable to keep him hydrated. This is what Alvarenga looked like when he washed up ashore last week in the Marshall Islands on a small fishing boat. He told authorities he had been lost at sea for 13 months after he and another fisherman had been caught in a storm off the Mexican Pacific coast. The other fisherman was identified by his family in Mexico as 23-year-old Ezequiel Cordova. Alvarenga says he died 4 weeks into the drift. During the long 13 months, he said, he also thought about ending his own life.
Twice, I thought a couple of times about killing myself. I grabbed the knife. When food and water ran out, I got depressed, and I would grab the knife and contemplate killing myself.
Alvarenga says he survived by eating raw turtles and fish and drinking rainwater and at times his own urine. The Mexican government is now helping Alvarenga return home to El Salvador.
And that is my main mission here, to facilitate the logistics, to make sure that, number one, he's healthy enough to travel, number two, that all documentation is in order, and number three, that we can get him together with his family as soon as possible.
Questions remain as to how a man could have survived for 13 months in the open sea, eating raw fish and turtles and drinking rainwater. But neither officials in the Marshall Islands nor the Mexican government diplomats who are assisting him have expressed any doubts about his story. Plans to help him return home to El Salvador have been postponed due to his worsening health condition. After being sent back to the hospital, doctors are now closely monitoring his progress. Rafael Romo, CNN, Atlanta.